So out of turn four, Brombolo gets to the loud pedal. Qualifying is underway for the KMSA Minis. Oh, wow. I guess. 2707 for Brombolo. This is their Daytona, the largest track they will compete again on. 20.573 for Tullis on lap one. Next two cars out, pulling out onto the speedway in the number nine machine. It will be Donnie Lowe and behind him in the in the 01 machine. It'll be Austin Baxley. So Austin Baxley trips the clock for his qualifying effort. And in the 78 machine, that'll be Marcus Thompson. So the 01's gonna cross the stripe. So Marcus goes to third quick and second quick in the 78. While the 01 goes third quick in this one. Super late models, you are next. We need you in qualifying. For qualifying, you are next. Again, super late models, get them staging. You are next.
No race.
So Micah Gavin in the M16 machine, the Georgia driver, making his trip up here to the Smoky Mountain Speedway. And behind him, Rodney Griffin in the number 97, making his second appearance in the KMSA this season. Micah Gavin takes it to the top point with a 19.681 on the first lap. 28.40 on lap number one for the number 97 of Rodney Griffin. And Rodney Griffin comes to a slow and pulls it in off turn two. 19.699, Michael Gavin laying down a quick lap here on the 4/10 mile sweep. Next machine out, a little bit out of his qualifying order, but he gets going. It'll be Donnie Lowe in the number nine machine, one of our Tennessee drivers, and coming up behind him in the number one, multiple KMSA national champion and longtime veteran to this series, out of Tuscaloosa, Alabama, is gonna be Bo Minor. And coming up, Greg. Donnie Lowe, one of our Tennessee boys, bringing the heat down the front stretch. He clocks in with a 22.905 on lap number one. Big bad Bo Minor coming out of turn four. He's gonna cross the stripe. 25.95 for Bo Minor, and he goes up to the fourth quick position. The Cleveland, Tennessee driver bringing it down the front stretch for Donnie Lowe. 22.524 for Mr. Lowe. Bo Minor keeping that thing pointed in the right direction. Second quick with a 23.72 for Bo Minor. So big bad Bo Minor goes to second. Next machine out in the number 14 out of Lenore City, Tennessee. It'll be Dylan Dugan.
Or Dugan, is that the Dugan family?
So Dylan Dugan. And the number 14 machine out of Lenore City. One of the locals making some noise, and behind him in the number 21E, They call him the Northeast Nightmare. Out of Toccoa, Georgia, picked up the KMSA win at the Sonoya Raceway. It'll be Mr. Shannon Etheridge. $25.51 for the 14 machine of Dylan Dugan as he goes to fourth quick. Shannon Etheridge piping it up out of turns four. Can the Northeast Nightmare go to the top? He goes to second quick with a 19.966. 24.15 for Mr. Dylan Dugan. $19.752 for Mr. Shannon Etheridge in the 21E.
Otherwise, he will be fascist.
Next machine out of the number 17. It'll be Tyler Haynes making his first KMSA start of the season. Coming behind him in the number 73 machine, it'll be Dustin Hallbrooks of Christiana, Tennessee. Hallbrooks made a few starts with KMSA in seasons past. 24.71 for the 17 machine of Tyler Haynes. And the 73, he's going to bring the heat down. 23.28 for him. Put the 17 up to third, 22.58 for him as he puts it up to the speed chart. 27.00 for the 73 machine.
Is that what it says in the number?
.002 for the 35 machine. 25 of David Singleton of Lenore City, Tennessee. Coming out of turn four to complete his first of two laps in the 717 machine. It'll be Bobby Wilson of Cleveland, Tennessee. 21.252 for the 25 machine as he crossed the stripe of Mr. Singleton, one of our Tennessee veterans. The 7-11 hanging it down to the bottom as he comes across to the stripe. Bobby Wilson, 22.470 as he crosses the stripe. Points leader out of Tennessee, it'll be Tony Kaufman. Already two wins to his credit this season with the KMSA. So Kaufman will trip the clock out of turns one as he gets his qualifying efforts underway. Jamie Rowan, one of the Georgia drivers, sneaking out. Austin Smith in the 20R sneaking out to the Speedway. 28.66 for Kaufman on lap number one. Austin Smith with a 28.57 on his first attempt. Kaufman, can the points leader get to the top of the board? 23.31, he goes to fifth quick. Austin Smith, a little loose off four. He'll bring it cross. 27.64 for the driver in the 20R machine. Next driver out in the 5X machine out of Coalfield, Tennessee. It'll be Joe Friels. And behind him in the number 21 machine out of Villarica, Georgia. We like to call him the Villarica Villain. Rookie of the Year of the KMSA back in 2016 is Todd Brewster. Southern All-Star Super Late Models. We need you in staging. You are next. Southern All-Star Super Late Models. We need you in staging. You are next. 22-4-3 for the 5X of Joe Friels. Todd Brewster, the Villarica villain, coming out of four. 22-6-4-7 for the young man out of Georgia. Nice pickup. 4-5 machine as he runs a 22-5-9 on his second go round. .21672 for Mr. Todd Brewster. Also out of Villarica, Georgia. And the number 18 is the Heartbreak Kid of Heath Brewster. And in the 21R, making the longest trip over here to the Smoky Mountain Speedway, it'll be Johnny Rauschenberg of Enid, Oklahoma. Heath Brewster definitely not up to a good pace right now as he's coming off turn four. Trying to get into the 19-second bracket. 22-7-2-7 on lap number one. 27-4-0 for our second driver out onto the speedway. So Heath Brewster comes again. 22-4-2-7 and the Oklahoma driver brings it across the stripe. 28-2-6 on lap two. Only. So coming out of turn four in the 20-yard machine out of Carrollton, Georgia, it'll be Mr. Jamie Rowan.
Keeps going back to 19-6-8-1. Be the same
car. 24-8-2-4 on lap number one for Rowan. Jamie Rowan, a former winner at the West Georgia Speedway out there in Whitesburg, Georgia. He comes back across the stripe. 24-2-3-5 on lap. Next car out. It'll be Derek Dugan out of North City, Tennessee as well. He will get his car up and rolling and in the number 28 machine. Out of Atala, Alabama, it's going to be Jeremy Griffin. Jeremy Griffin, multiple top fives when they went to Columbus, Mississippi in the Jackson Motor Speedway during that doubleheader. He walked out with two top threes. 19-8-8-1 for the seven of the Atala, Alabama driver. Great lap for him. 21-2-5-2 on lap one, 4-28. Dugan comes back across the stripe, a 19-9-0-0 on lap number two, getting into the 19-second bracket. Dale Tyler, Alabama driver, coming out of turn four. Trying to get a good lap running. He crossed the stripe, 21-2-0-8. So bringing a heat out of turn four in the number 99 machine.
No driver registered.
Behind him in the number 12.
Oh, no.
It'll be Dustin Stevens pulling out onto the Speedway, 21-221 for the 99 machine. $25.98 for the 12 of Dustin Stevens. Out of turn for the 99, really trying to get a good lap. $28.75, nice little pickup for him. Dustin Stevens brings the heat out of four. Can he break that 19-second barrier? Not quite. 25.49 on lap number two for Dustin Stevens. Donnie Turpin. And in the C11 out of Knoxville, Tennessee, it's going to be Michael Courtney. Michael Courtney, one of the ones you want to keep your eyes on, as he's one of the hot shoes here in the Tennessee area. So green flag is out for the final two qualifiers for KMSA qualifying. $27.67 for Donnie Turpin. $23.23 for Michael Courtney. $27.41 on lap two. Michael Courtney got a nice smooth line out of four. Can he break the 19-second barrier? Not quite. 23.86 on lap two. Report to staging. You're next. Heat races. KMSA, we need you in staging. Y'all are next. They're going to come out of turn four, and they're going to mash the loud pedal down to the firewall, and they are all here at Smoky Mountain Speedway for heat race number one. Oh, three wide. Look at Kevin Tullis getting into the mix. He's not going to hold it long, as the guys to the outside will pick up the speed and the momentum. Down in the turns three and four they go. Lap number one is about to be put in the books by Holbrook. So right now the battle between the pair of 70 plus cars is they're gonna battle it out of turn number four. Tullis to wind the Georgia driver. Lurking back there in third as lap number two is now in the books. So far the field is single file on this gigantic 0.4 mile speed plant for the KMSA series. Lap three, they will cross the strike. So Marcus Thompson leading the pack down the backstretch. He's getting the charge from Dustin Holbrook. Side by side in the turns three and four. Holbrook trying to get around Thompson, but cannot quite make it work. As they cross the strike, to the top side they go. Dustin Holbrook trying to slingshot him down the backstretch. Down into three and four they go. The battle for the lead still getting hot and heavy as they come out of four. One more time around. So Holbrook takes a swipe down in turns one. Thompson's going to hold a point as he heads down the backstretch. Holbrook bump drafting him in three and four. Side by side for the lead. Whoa, a drag race. Give it to Holbrook as he slingshots him out of four and wins heat race number one. Marcus Thompson second. And Austin Brumbelow will round out your top three. So they're off for KMSA heat race number two. Your pole man, Dustin Dugan, hanging it to the outside and has taken a point from the points leader, Tony Kaufman. How about that bump drafting down there in the turns one and two, the 01? Showing up, Austin Baxley, trying to get the fourth place machine car loose as they battle down the backstretch. Down in a three and four, the battle for fifth, starting to get real hot and heavy as they come out of four. Lap number one is now in the books. Kaufman trying to give chase to the local boy of Dylan Dugan. So we continue to stay green flag racing. The 01 machine of Austin Baxley challenging the 21R for fourth. All the way from Eden, Oklahoma, Johnny Rauschenberg trying to hold off. And Austin Baxley takes it back from him, and he'll go up to fourth.
Dugan won one of the Southern All-Star Goblins.
White flag out for the race leader. Dylan Dugan showing away in the turns one and two. Tony Kaufman trying to give chase, but just don't have enough race car to make up the difference. Rodney Griffin running third. Austin Baxley fourth. And the Oklahoma driver round out the top five. But Dylan Dugan out of Lenore, Tennessee will pick up heat race win number two over Tony Kaufman. Rodney Griffin coming home third, fourth to Austin Baxley. And Johnny Rauschenberg will round out the top five, and Heath Brewster come home sixth. Green flag out for the third and final KMSA Heat Boat Miner. Spun the tires on the start. That's going to cost him dearly as he goes into one and two and a fall back to third. So Dustin Stevens showing away down the backstretch in the blue 12, and Chuck McMahon coming home in second right now as they complete lap number one. So down the backstretch they go. Dustin Stevens still showing away. Chuck McMahon back there in second, but Bo Miner, the Tuscaloosa native, starting to get that number one working as he's going to try to go around the 99. He's going to set him up out of turn number two. Down the backstretch they go. Bo Miner down to the bottom, keeping that car as straight as he can on that Ford Mustang, and they continue to battle it out for second.
Who is that 99?
Chuck McMahon.
What a move down there in turns one and two. He gets it down to the bottom. Wheel to wheel, hub to hub down the backstretch into turns three and four.
White flag.
White flag coming out, but the battle for second is raging out of four. And McMahon gets it back in front of him as he's trying to hold him off. Momentum is the game here with the KMSA mini stocks on this big high bank 4/10 mile speed plant. Boat digging down to the bottom, but Dustin Stevens will win heat race number three. McMahon second and Bo Miner third. Fourth coming home will be Joe Freels.
Freeze, something like that.
Oh, give it 20 to the 28 of Jeremy Griffin, winning by nose in fifth. And big bad boss man Alan Brewster. Micah Gavin, I've told you from the start in practice, that is a very fast race car. He jumps to the loud pedal and the thundering bumblebees are off. Stand corrected. 18 to go. We're only going 20 in this one. Side by side for the third position as they run them down the backstretch. The Kentucky Derby style, Smoky Mountain Speedway out of the KMSA Modified. They're coming out to the front stretch. Ah, what a tie coming to Lamba, give it to the number five. But the seven's gonna put the slider. Going into turns one and two. That'll be Darren Dugan. Ah, three wide on the backstretch. These guys are starting to whip into work early in this one. Side by side. High side momentum working to the advantage. Tony Kaufman getting up there. Tony Kaufman leads the KMSA points. Oh my, I call this the Daytona, the Talladega. This is the largest dirt track that KMSA is gonna visit. Slingshot and bump drafting. Good old fashioned restricted plate style racing. But this race will be determined by attrition. Side by side, Tony Kaufman getting into the mix. Kevin Tullis just made a big beeline move. He's gonna take that 3-for-1 clearance rack special from Kmart, all four. Whoa, buddy. Show them the boys how you get around Winder as he comes around here. So Dugan not wasting no time. The Lenore City driver pushing up on Shannon Etheridge. They're gonna go 3 wide for a second. Whoa, hang on, boy. So Dugan, Derek Dugan, trying to get around Shannon Etheridge. Etheridge picked up the big win down at the Gumbo at Sonoya Raceway. But he's got to hold off one of the strong boys here out of Tennessee. So Heath Brewster going to go a lap down. Todd Brewster, former KMSA winner at Sonoya on Illinois. Here comes one that blew up. Oh, Kevin Tullis in the green three up in flames. Caution out on the speedway.
Big old buff smoke.
So Kevin Tullis, the Winder Bar, the Winder Georgia driver. So and they sound the bell for the Hornet's Nest and it's off. Good God Almighty, Michael Gavin got a run on that backstretch and he's already took a 6-7 car length lead, but the battle for second is starting to erupt. Double D, Derek Dugan, Shannon Etheridge side by side for that high side move coming off Etheridge. He comes to the line. Good racing here. One is down off the pace and turns four. He's gonna make the hard right turn into the pit area. We stay racing. Caution out onto the speedway. So both 20 cars coming to a slow. Night ending for Austin Smith. So Jamie Rowan eighth in the points. This will be a hard hit for him for being part of the KMSA 2017 season. But they get back to the loud pedal. Oh, they're gonna be a 3-wide start. Here we go. So off into turns one and two, they go 3-wide. Boy, here we go again. These guys are getting around the speedway. The battle for second. Derek Dugan not showing any remorse out of force. He continues to challenge. Caution out. All right, here we go again. Let's see if this big steel cage match for the second position between Shannon Etheridge And Derek Dugan can commence. And this time, Derek Dugan just set that thing in there like Snoop Dogg in a Cadillac. Down the back stretch, he goes. He's going to take the point. Shannon Etheridge, the Northeast Nightmare, trying to answer him back. He gave him a shot, and that was the big boost. Oh, we got one around in turns four. Caution out onto the Speedway. Singleton in the 0-1. 13 laps in, 7 to go. Green flag. Well, oh, we got one definitely off the pace in turns four. Presence of mind to get up and around that number 5X. So down the back stretch, they go to battle for second. It's wide open. This time, Etheridge up on him, and Dugan drives it in hard, trying to knock on the door. They come to the line. The 73 and the 12. Really getting it in the third. Heat race winner, Stevens, trying to get up there to fourth. But Holbrook holding his own. But that battle for second, that's one of the best races on the track right now. Dugan trying to get around. Oh, Etheridge, but Shannon Etheridge, the Northeast Nightmare, putting on the clinic, heading down the backstretch, holding on for all he got. Meanwhile, Michael Gavin, oh, those boys getting loose as they come to the line. But your leader, Michael Gavin, got a little bit loose. Dugan beat Etheridge to the line. He's going to slide drop him in 1 and 2. We got a one around in turns four. Here we go again, they're back to the loud pedal and they're off. Micah Gavin absolutely running a flawless race tonight as he has dominated all 15 laps so far. 5 to go in this one. Derek Dugan, gonna see if he can answer the challenge of the 16 and get one for the local boys here tonight. Shannon Etheridge running third, the 73 machine. Sitting there back there in fourth out of Dustin Holbrook. Dustin Stevens in fifth, trying to hold off Bo Miner as they're battling for a top five position. 3 to go in this one. Oh, Holbrook getting high. 3 wide on turn number 2. He bounced off the wall and they're gonna squeeze Stevens out. Look at the minor boys getting into it. Throw up the bullhorns, 2 to go. Tony Kaufman is starting to make a run up. Chuck McMahon trying to hold off Kaufman. The top 5 is getting settled in. Oh, Shannon Etheridge, the Northeast Nightmare. Bringing a caution out, looping it into the middle, 3 and 4.
That's called cutting your tire, I think.
Flag out, Michael Gavin's gonna pick up the win.
Top six across the scale.
Derek Dugan coming home in second. Holbrook third, unfortunately, because the 21 spun it out of Shannon Etheridge, so that will put him tail end of the lead lap and the final results. Southern All-Star, Super Late Models, final call for you. You should be in staging. It's go time, gentlemen. Again, Southern All-Star, Super Late Models, it final call for you. We need you in staging immediately so we can get this nice 40-lapper up and rolling.